entrance to the underworld. He discovers halfway up the slope a cave that opens on a stream of clear flowing water where he sits. Moist air quivers like a membrane, skin that extends the nerves in his own skin, allows him to feel the world as proximate, unbounded, to eliminate movement, overcome by a conviction he can't name. The opening to the cave. Thank you. the abyss. It never scares me to think of the pearl in its depth, then let go of everything. Welcome the descent. Discover on the way I am the pearl descending, and let go that too. So why be terrified to see someone else do the same, knowing it's the only way to leave and return renewed? Bon voyage, my dear one. Remain out of range below as long as you must. Then come back and write to me.
Thank you.
Buddhist eschatology. Driving north on the Palisades Parkway, glad to be alive in July, after a month of heavy rains, the greens are tropical in my garden in Glens Falls, lush with yellow squash, 3 weeks ahead of last year. After talking with Bernie about the anger he harbors at his fear of dying alone, in which he locates the whole of Buddhist eschatology. The terror our species imposes on the world will bring about the next dark age. Realize I may as easily die into love. The heart at last unbound. And fall through years of grace with my wife and daughter into the heartache of my childhood. Dissolve happily into the closing lotus of my mother's womb. A garden growing backward.
Thank you.
Big Bang. Once brilliant squash blossoms hang on the fence, like forlorn suns stopped in orbit by last night's frost. I pick the largest peppers and tomatoes, harvest basil, the smell of it expanding with each broken leaf. I think about abundance, too much of everything to contain, even dying. The world spills over into itself. All this exploded from a single point, from nothingness. Black. You are well fitted into the world, you have earned your place, and you know how to conduct yourself with grace. And for that, I feel the gods will give you favor. Love, Max. Jung spent his middle years like Dante, exploring the underworld to answer as closely as imagination would allow the decisive question, are we related or not to something infinite? If there ever were an initiation to such a world, it's this one I enter, infused with chemicals that are both cure and poison. Pharmacon does both to me at the same time. A rabbit hole I fall through, a world where the borders of worlds dissolve. Expected, filled with the fear of death, a walk through the valley of the shadow. I am David without sling or kingdom, or certainty I might think my way out of this condition, but find myself entangled in invisible roots of what is unknowable, that combine to form structures more quickly then I can hold on to them. I'm forced to let go. Into absolute absence. Everything that held the world together, swallowed by that faceless face. Abandonment. Until it seems I have no choice but to embrace it. Decipher its message. Nothing else to do on the way to a destination which has always been the center of a circle squared. Suddenly realize just how important it is. I fall in love with whatever I find there. To the horsemen. At times I find myself so full of grief, it spills over. Unannounced, stronger than conviction, curiosity, or epiphany, or the desire for relief. Embraces me like a lover, begs whispered secrets, a confidant who will never betray a confidence shared with anyone, anytime. Finds me where the moment is most vivid, makes it even more so as I shed trappings old age refuses to sustain, bare necessity as a trifle. Full-voiced in grief, grateful it cares enough to find me still. Thank you. So, we traveled, my oarsman's ears stuffed with beeswax against the siren's deadly song, so only I could hear it. And every time I cried out, they tied me, as ordered, more securely to the mast. part of this narrative took 9 years from beginning to end. What do I make of this in the autumn of my years, when the leaves turn crisp as hair on a head otherwise bare? It is different from the tale I told back then, less clear. I was not one of them and can't really know what they saw or felt. None who manned the oars, ears stuffed with beeswax, survived to tell me. Thank you. Museum of the Infinite to Douglas. The museum of which you speak, Douglas, has no vanishing point. Everything in the open. No hide and seek for what explains our journey between meaning and menace. Like the God particle that links mind to matter, our universe, one of many, nested in a regressus of black holes, ends, where mortality ceases to burden the human heart. I want to stroll this museum with you, old friend, as if we'd been here all along. Watch our corridors, watch the corridors of our assumptions dissolve around portraits hanging in plain sight, without walls or frames.
Thank you.
Joe Fiedler, Anna Weber, Dana Lynn, Michel Gentile, Matt Pavolka, Rob Garcia, and Daniel Kelly. Thank you so much for coming. Appreciate it. Thank you.